Welcome to Learn It. Today we'll be discussing about class 10th science unit 5, which is life process. And from here the topic 1, which is the major portion of this chapter, starts. This topic will be comprising, or what we will be learning today is given below, which is the first will be the introduction, the second will be the mode of nutrition, third will be autotrophic nutrition, fourth raw material for photosynthesis, site of photosynthesis, main events occurring in the photosynthesis, stomata and functions of the stomata. Today we'll be discussing these 8 topics, which will be including in topic 1. So let us talk about what is introduction of this chapter. As you all know that all the living things perform certain life process, like every organism require growth, require to do excretion, respire and circulate to get a healthy life or to live a life. All these processes like respiration, digestion, which together keep the living organism alive and perform the job of body maintenance, are called life process. Basically all the things which keeps a body working or in a working condition, it comes under life process. In this topic we'll be discussing about the modes of nutrition. Now the modes have been divided into 2 parts, one in the plants and second one in the animals. So we'll be discussing first about the plants. The plants are basically called as autotrophs because they make their own food with the help of photosynthesis. As we have learned it from a very small age, that the plants do photosynthesis for their food production. And the second thing is that all the organism directly or indirectly depend on these kind of organisms or plants only, which means all the organisms depend on plants in one or other way. The second mode of nutrition is in animals. As we all know that all organism or all animals depend on plants, that's why it is called as heterotrophs. Now what does the heterotrophs means is that heterotrophs means the organism which depend on other organism or plants for their food. So these are dependent organisms which depend on other organism or plant for their mode of food. Let's start with the topic autotrophic nutrition, which only happens in plant. Now it is a kind of nutrition in which inorganic material like carbon dioxide, water, etc. are utilized to prepare organic food. By the process of photosynthesis is called autotrophic mode of nutrition. It is basically definition. Now we'll take the example. We already know that only the green plants have the power to do photosynthesis. That's why only the green plants are called autotrophic plants or take autotrophic mode of nutrition. Now the organism which carry out autotrophic nutrition will obviously be called as autotrophs, and auto means, or trops means only green plants. Now autotrophs use these kind of simple inorganic material and convert it into complex high energy molecules like carbohydrates, or in plant section it is called as glucose also. Carbohydrate is also known as glucose. It means we'll be taking some of the inorganic material like the material of carbon dioxide, water, etc. and with the help of sunlight, the energy, the chloroplast and the material inside the leaves will convert that inorganic material into organic material, which is known as carbohydrates. So now let us discuss about the equation of photosynthesis. So before that I'll read out. Autotrophic nutrition is fulfilled by the process of which autotrophs take in carbon dioxide and water and convert these into carbohydrate in the presence of chlorophyll, sunlight, is called photosynthesis. Now let me explain it, what the equation says. It says the 6 carbon dioxide molecule when merged with 12 water molecules. Now on the arrow it is written sunlight and chlorophyll. What does it mean? The 6 carbon dioxide molecules when mixed with 12 water molecules in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll gives out C6H12O6, which is known as the formula for glucose or carbohydrate. And it gives us also 2 things, which is 6 oxygen molecules and 6 water molecules. So this is the basic or the major equation for photosynthesis. I'll repeat it again. The 6 carbon dioxide when merged with 12 water molecules in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll gives out C6H12O6, which means 1 molecules of glucose, 6 molecules of oxygen and 6 molecules of water in air. Now we'll be discussing about the raw materials of photosynthesis. So basically there are four materials which are required for the plant to do the photosynthesis, as we can see it from the screen also. I'll just read it out for you, which is sunlight. Basic and the foremost thing is sunlight. Without this, no photosynthesis process will take place. The second is chlorophyll, which is present in the leaves. Third is carbon dioxide, and fourth is water. Now where does sunlight come from? Sunlight comes from sun. Chlorophyll is present in the plant leaves. Carbon dioxide we get from the atmosphere, and water is dissolved in the soil and we'll take it from the underground. Now from the diagram also we can understand the four basic things, and one in the last portion there is written sugar. When this four material combines, it forms a kind of sugar or a kind of carbohydrate which is utilized by the another organism or by the plant for their functioning. So the first point is sunlight. It is inorganic material which comes from sun. Second is chlorophyll. Chlorophyll helps in the absorption of sunlight and convert these into energy. The third is carbon dioxide, which enters through stomata and releases oxygen as a byproduct from the stomata. Now what is the stomata and what is the structure of a stomata, we'll be studying in our next topic. The last topic is known as water. Water with many material like nitrogen, phosphorus, etc., like they are also been taken from the roots from the soil. Now let us move to the site of photosynthesis. Where does this photosynthesis occurs? As you can see it from the first diagram and the second diagram. The first diagram is just the big representation of the second diagram, in which you can see the stomata written, which is section C. So let me discuss about the first topic or the first picture. Now it look like a sandwich to us, but basically it is a part of a leaf. When we cut a leaf, its transverse section look like this when we look it from side and with the help of microscope. So in the lower section, in a lower section all the stomata and guard cells are present, and on the top all the cuticle is present. Cuticle means the uppermost layer of a leaf. After that there will be a series of cells which contains cytoplasm and nucleus, and in that cell there will be some chloroplast cell also. Now what is chloroplast doing? The sunlight which falls on the upper part of the leaves absorbs the heat or absorbs the solar energy and transport it to this kind of chloroplast. Now chloroplast contains chlorophyll, which will convert these sunlight with the help of some of the other things like carbon dioxide and water into photosynthesis process, which is called as glucose. Now in the second sequence we can see, in the second image we can see a leaves and a transverse section when it is cut will look like something, the section C. Now in C one cell has been enlarged, in which we can clearly see where is chloroplast, and in that chloroplast the last topic will be how does a chloroplast look. It basically has outer membrane, inner membrane, some of the coin shaped thylakoids, and the fluid called stroma is filled there. In this section only of a plant the photosynthesis occurs, not in the whole plant the photosynthesis occurs. This topic will contains the events of the photosynthesis, what all things will be happening during the photosynthesis. The first is the absorption of light energy by the chlorophyll of the leaves. In chlorophyll, the conversion of light energy into chemical energy will be happening, and in that the splitting of water, which means the splitting of H2O will be there, and which release hydrogen and oxygen into different manners, which mean H2O will be divided into H2 and O. And the third is the reduction of CO2 to carbohydrate, which means the conversion of carbon dioxide into carbohydrate forms will be there. The last topic for this video will be the stomata. We'll be discussing about where the stomata will be present and what are the structure of the stomata. The basic presence of stomata is under the surface of the leaves, which means on the lower section of the leaves. Now what does the stomata means is they are the tiny pores or tiny openings present below the surface of the leaves. Now what does the functions of stomata or what does a stomata do is, the first thing is it helps in the exchange of gases like oxygen and carbon dioxide in and out of the plant. The second is when the water content is high in a plant, it also helps in the process of doing transpiration, and it helps or it will let the water to lose it from the plant body in case if there is lot of it. So you can see a arrow there which takes us to a bigger image of the stomata, in which we can see two stomata, one is open one and second one is closed one. Basically there are three main parts of the stomata. The two kidney shaped or bean shaped are called as guard cells. The middle opening is known as stomatal pore, and in the guard cells there are chloroplast present which help in the process of photosynthesis. That's it for today's video. I hope you have understood the topics very well. But for more understanding, I urge all of you to repeat this video again for clearer understanding. If you like the video and its content, give it a thumbs up and don't forget to comment your name in the comment section. If you are unable to understand or is struggling in any of the topic, please write the topic in the comment section. I'll surely try to get to you soon. So for more of such videos, stay tuned to the channel, stay safe, stay healthy, and don't forget to learn it.